DNA isolation. The aim of the experiment is to isolate DNA from the plant source. Here we are taking onion for this experiment. Materials required: test tube with test tube stand, sodium chloride, tilt ethanol, beaker and a glass rod, funnel, pestle and mortar for grinding the food material that we have chosen for our experiment. Spatula, glass cylinder, onion. For this experiment I have taken onion. Any other plant material can also be taken. For example, spinach or strawberry. A banana can also be taken, and a filter paper, liquid detergent. So let's proceed with the experiment. The very first step is blending. We are going to blend the onion to a paste. The purpose of blending process is that it degrades the cell walls and the membranes further, permitting the release of DNA. We don't have to blend it for too long as it will break up the DNA fibers. After blending it, then we are going to prepare our extraction buffer. For preparing the extraction buffer, we take a glass beaker. In the glass beaker, we would add liquid detergent to it. 5 ml of liquid detergent I have taken approximately. To the liquid detergent, we'll add sodium chloride. Why liquid detergent is used? Because the detergent and the heat treatment, it degrades the membrane phospholipids and proteins, releasing the DNA. Sodium chloride, approximately 2 to 3 grams I have taken. I have mixed it with the liquid detergent. Now I'll add warm water to it. Because the heat treatment, by adding water, it would degrade the membrane phospholipids and it would help in separation of the membrane and release of DNA. Slowly, gently by the side, I have added water. The entire process is to be carried out gently so as to avoid the entry of air bubbles into it. We'll mix it thoroughly. This is our extraction buffer. Now it is ready. The next step is the onion paste which we have prepared. We are going to transfer it into the extraction buffer. And after transferring it, we'll leave it for some time undisturbed for at least 15 to 20 minutes so that the DNA can be released and it can come out from the cell. The onion paste is transferred into the extraction buffer and we are going to mix it thoroughly now. The salt is added because the positively charged sodium ions from the salt shield the negatively charged phosphate groups of the DNA molecules, helping them to precipitate out of the solution. Gently, we are going to add by the side the leftover amount of water so that the solution becomes 100 ml. We've used warm water for this particular experiment. This extraction buffer, along with the paste, onion paste, we are going to leave it for some time, at least for 20 minutes. Now we are going to, the next step is filtering out the solid from it. We'll take the glass cylinder and we'll place the funnel into it. We'll fold the filter paper and place the filter paper in the funnel. and gently we are going to pour the solution into the funnel. And we have to make sure that there is no air bubble. The solution that we get in the measuring cylinder, we will transfer it into the test tube, into a clean test tube, and then we'll add chilled ethanol to it. And we have to ensure that it is added drop by the side so as to avoid any air bubble, and it forms a layer at the top. Why we used chilled ethanol? Because it slows down the breakdown of DNA, which would occur if a high temperature is maintained. And ethanol, it will precipitate into the upper layer. The DNA, which is the white material, it would be clearly seen in the alcohol layer. We'll leave it for some time. For 10 to 20 minutes, we'll leave it. I have already made a solution in which I have already added the alcohol, the chilled ethanol I have already added, and which I have already kept for 15 to 20 minutes. As you can see clearly on the top in the ethanol layer, you can see the entangled mass of DNA. The white substance that you can see floating at the top, this is DNA. The thread-like structure, entangled mass, we are able to clearly see. DNA isolation. Aim: to isolate DNA from available plant materials such as spinach, green pea seeds, papaya, onion, etc. Materials required: plant materials such as spinach, green pea seeds, papaya, onion, etc. 5 gram liquid detergent, 2 gram sodium chloride, chilled ethanol, 95% isopropyl alcohol, distilled water, test tube, funnel, filter paper, test tube stand, pestle and mortar, and the beaker. Principle: deoxyribonucleic acid DNA is a genetic material in plants and animals. The recombinant DNA technology has allowed the introduction of DNA in other organisms, including bacteria, yeast, animals, and plants. These organisms are called as genetically modified organisms. Thus, recombinant DNA technology involves isolation of DNA from a variety of sources. Procedure: make the paste of onion with the help of a pestle and mortar so as to break the cell's walls. In a beaker, mix the liquid detergent, salt, and 100 ml warm distilled water. Stir gently, trying to avoid making too many bubbles in the mixture. This is the extraction buffer. Add the extraction buffer to the onion paste and mix again. Leave the onion extraction mixture to incubate for 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, filter the extraction mixture through a filter paper. This will remove all the solid material that we don't want. We would be left with a clear liquid. Transfer this liquid in a test tube. Pour 10 ml of chilled ethanol carefully down the side of the test tube to form a layer on the top of the content. Let it stand for some time. Observation: at the interface of alcohol and onion, we would see white cloud-like substance forming. The addition of ethanol to the solution causes DNA to precipitate. The DNA fibers appear as white precipitate of very fine threads. Precautions: the plant material should be clean so that there is no dust particles sticking to it. All the glassware should be thoroughly dried and cleaned. The chilled ethanol should be added slowly by the side so as to avoid the entry of air bubbles to it. This is the double-stranded DNA that you can see in the image. We have to draw the diagram also when we are doing the practical. The backbone of the DNA is formed by sugar and phosphate and purines and pyrimidine bases are present. Based on this, you can get the viva questions based on the structure of DNA. You can be asked the precautions to be taken in the viva.